Star Wars, Crusade of the Rebellion, by Joe Harrison. Based on characters and situations created by George Lucas. Episode 3, Under Fire. Long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, there came a time of revolution when rebels united to challenge a tyrannical empire. But while this galactic civil war raged on in the open, notable events also took place elsewhere within the shadows. Colonel Dalvin Ledok has been rescued from his prison cell on Premta 4 by Kyle Katarn and Jan Ors, two of the Alliance's top agents. But this success is short-lived. Now charged with the task of escaping the Empire and getting off the planet, the trio look to hope and perhaps something more, as the odds will surely be stacked against them.
Jan, you read me?
Barely. Doesn't look too good out here, Kyle. I think they know something's up.
Well, it was only a matter of time. I've got the colonel. We're making our way out to the front door right now. We're the troopers.
Smack dab in front of the main door.
Of course. Which way are they facing?
Two are facing the door, while the others are looking the other way.
Let me know if that changes. Kyle out. All right. Colonel, take this extra comm link in case we get separated.
Well, this'll be fun. I was kinda hoping you had a plan for getting out.
You haven't noticed. Organization isn't one of the Alliance's best qualities. I take back what I said about your good arm.
Hey, that's the one you knocked out.
Where are you going?
I saw an armory back there.
Jan, you're under fire. What? Jan, repeat. I couldn't hear you. Jan! Jan!
Get out of there. There are troops. In and out, he said. A simple mission, he said. A simple mission, mine.
Hey, someone's climbing down the side of the building.
You, identify yourself.
Frag.
Guards, detain her.
Detain this.
She's got a rocket launcher.
Sound the alarm. Command Outpost 3. Send reinforcements immediately to the main prison complex. Repeat, Command Outpost 3. Send reinforcements to the main prison complex.
Where is that blasted arms locker? Terrific. Here it is.
Want to second guess that maneuver, Rebel scum?
Doesn't look like I have a choice. Well, except for kicking this table.
Open fire!
Katarn, come in.
A little busy, Colonel.
They've got me pinned down in the armory. I'm stuck behind an overturned table. Not gonna last much longer.
Well, as soon as I figure out how to be in two places at once, I'll be right there.
Give up, Rebel. We've got you cornered.
There has to be something in here. Within reach. Oh, of course. Blast you, Ledok. You forgot this was a prison facility, which means any weapons are going to be under lock and key. Oh, I'm getting too old for this.
Oh.
blaster's almost dead. What else do I have here? What's this? A concussion grenade! Jan, you beautiful woman. Ugh. Hey, hey, hold your fire! Hold your fire!
Finally, a rebel with sense. We accept your surrender.
Not so fast. Don't you think this is a little crazy? I mean, it's not going anywhere. How's about we come to a compromise, huh? Well, I gave him the chance.
What? What's this? You can't bring grenades to a firefight. It's unethical!
Sorry, but my blaster's out. And you've got 10 seconds to round the... oops. More like 2 seconds.
Grabbing one of these... Stormtrooper's blasters is... bought me some more time.
Surrender, rebel scum, or I'll blast you into a pile of ash!
Yeah, well, too bad you can't shoot straighter. Haha, gotcha. Now I've just gotta find a way to... Blast! An AT-ST! This is gonna be fun! That thing's gonna blow me to pieces! But my blaster isn't worth a Hutt's ransom against that thing's armor. One rocket left. All right, Jan. Make it count. Steady. Steady.
If I don't get mowed down by blaster fire, I'm gonna get cooked alive by this table. It's getting hot from all the laser bolts.
You've got 15 seconds to surrender, Rebel.
I wish you were here with me, Jaden Dodonna. I could always count on you to devise a quick plan. Of course, you'd probably just say,
just run up and shoot.
Move forward, boys.
But seeing as I don't have any weapons, and there are far too many of them... Oh, this is best if only I... Oh! What the... wall behind me just exploded. Looks like an Imperial walker just crashed through the side of this building. Someone standing in the wreckage.
Cowering behind a table like a little lost bantha cub? That's something I'd expect from Kyle, not a seasoned war vet.
Nobody's perfect.
Come on, Colonel.
What about Katarn?
You called?
Attaboy, Kyle.
The least I could do. I guess we're even now.
Even? Kyle, it'll take a lot more than that to make us even.
I know.
You can tally up your points later. We gotta get out of here.
Yeah, anger's over there. Come on.
There's another one right there.
Behind you.
Got him.
Oh, frag. There's another group coming up behind us. Looks like they're setting up an E-Web.
It's okay. Our ship's right there. See?
Oh. What the?
Don't even start. We've heard every metaphor imaginable for how bad our ship looks.
Oh, yeah? Well, how's about a bantha's shape?
Okay, that's a new one.
That thing's gonna tear us apart!
Here, get in, quick!
Ladies first.
Great time for etiquette.
Move!
Are you sure this ship can get off the ground?
You bet she can. Strap yourself in, Colonel. Next stop, deep space. Eyeballs coming in at 0.50.
Can't outrun the TIE fighters.
I know. Switching laser cannons to manual.
I always hate at this part.
Laser cannons charged. Firing.
Nice shooting!
Are we clear of the atmosphere yet?
Almost. Locking coordinates.
Stupid eyeball. Could you just stay in one place? For just... one... second!
Nice shooting!
We're clear. Jumping in 3, 2, 1!
Well, not quite the rescue mission I was expecting.
You can say that again.
Yeah, but thanks. Thanks for getting me out of there.
You're welcome, but you probably shouldn't thank us just yet.
And why's that?
Let's just say, Mothma has plans for you.
Oh, great.
Recorder on. Personal log. Code 250 Auric Delta 1. On my desk, I have a stone tablet. Superb condition. Certainly better than its age would imply. The tablet was uncovered in the excavations on Apophis, and I believe it holds the key to unlocking the true power contained in these artifacts. The room is dim, and the scent from the synth sensors is almost overpowering, but I believe it simulates the atmosphere in which this stone tablet was inscribed. The hieroglyphs bear a striking resemblance to the previous tablet. Although, I'm noticing many errors. Disorder. The first tablet was much smoother in its inscriptions, more stylized, more confident. But this... the author's hand was trembling. Fear. I see fear in this. Let me see. The others did not understand the power. They have died, taken their eyes, yet they see in darkness. They watch me. As the sun falls, they come closer. Great power. Power of shadows. I have cloaked. I have hidden the four. Must come. Must bring to an end.
Commander Hawk to Lord Teivel.
Commander Hawk, perhaps you recall a certain discussion we had a few weeks ago about disturbing me when
again,
I'm...
Again, I apologize, sir. We have another incoming vessel.
Oh, no. showing up at my door. Well, what do they want?
They're requesting the shields be deactivated so they can dispatch a shuttle.
And who is they, Commander?
They are the Star Destroyer Vengeance, sir.
Jerec. Commander, have Mr. Kale meet me on the landing platform. Best behavior, Mr. Kale. We mustn't give them a reason to stay any longer than they have to.
Governor Teivel.
Lord Jerec. Forgive me, my lord. I was not aware you were coming.
We were on our way to Imperial Center. However, I wanted a chance to stop and take a look at these significant superweapons the Emperor spoke of.
Well, they are not really superweapons, my lord.
They have the ability to destroy planets, do they not?
Well, yes, but...
Then they are superweapons.
Yes, I suppose so.
Well, are you not going to introduce me to your rather large companion?
Forgive me, my lord. This is Mr. Kale, my bodyguard.
A pleasure, I'm sure. You are quite massive for a human, Mr. Kale. A man of few words. A rare luxury to find that in officers these days. Consider yourself fortunate, Governor. I believe you have already met Captain Thrawn?
Briefly, some time ago. Captain?
Governor?
Captain Thrawn was as anxious to see these three vessels.
Well... I was just about to sit down to dinner, if you would care to join me, and I will take you on a tour of the facility afterward.
I accept. Captain?
Yes, sir.
I hope you are enjoying your Brualki, sir.
Indeed. Finally braised.
There's been some talk of some sort of upset on Preemptor 4.
Yes, indeed. A rebel officer of some importance, as I understand it. The Colonel, Dalvin Ledok.
Is that so? I wasn't made aware of that.
Yes, a rather bold move by the Rebellion. A great deal of risk for one man.
Yet they succeeded.
Yet they succeeded.
I wonder, Governor, if you might be able to shed some light on reports we intercepted recently.
To what reports are you referring, Captain?
I'm referring to reports of excavations in the Ptolemaic system, on the planet Apophis. Intelligence stumbled across encoded transmissions between Apophis and Cortanus. I was also able to determine that two Star Destroyers currently stationed over Apophis bear names and identification numbers linked to your command.
What exactly are you suggesting, Captain?
I am merely curious, Governor. Apophis was once home to an ancient civilization.
Indeed. I have done my research, Captain. As you are aware, I have degrees in anthropology and archaeology.
Yes, I understand you are quite fascinated with those subjects. I just wonder if it's as innocent as that.
Say what you mean, Captain Thrawn.
Analysis of the ancient civilization in question revealed that they had discovered a mysterious power deep in the Earth. According to mythology, something they referred to as black water drowned three-quarters of the planet's population in a day.
And with your impeccable logic, what do you suppose that black water was?
Investigations have not
Have been you convinced. Ever heard of petroleum, Captain?
Petroleum? Ah, yes. A natural subterranean oil used for fuels and lubricants.
Indeed, Captain. Fuels and lubricants for heavy machinery.
Are you implying that the black water spoken of in Apophian mythology was nothing more than natural oil?
I'm not implying, Captain. I know. We have discovered a large cache of petroleum in the caverns beneath the planet's surface.
But what would
this
you...
This is a shipyard, is it not? We do not build our vessels by wishing them into existence. We build them with machinery.
Ah, a fine dinner indeed.
You're not eating, Captain.
The captain eats in his own time.
Does he? Interesting.
Quite. I find the more I discover about Thrawn and his species, the more I am... amused.
A shame we encounter so few. Tell me, Captain, why do your people hide in the shadows? Are they afraid? Surely they've heard how well-treated you are, and of your status in the Imperial Navy. Not to mention Supreme Commander Tom.
We have our reasons, Governor, and that Katarr was a traitor.
Was she? But I heard you were the one who introduced her to
her to the Emperor, but her loyalty fell elsewhere.
Did it now? Hmm.
Loyalty. Loyalty can be such a delicate quality to possess, made all the more difficult when duty demands loyalty, where one feels it is not deserved.
I suppose.
You do agree, Governor. You try to hide that fact, but I can sense that you agree. Tell me, Governor, where do you stand on the subject of our dear Emperor?
I'm not sure what you mean, sir.
Oh, but you do. Remember whom you are talking to, Governor Teivel. I am no mindless Imperial. I can see your thoughts as clearly as you can see me. You are unhappy with his rule.
I have committed my life to his rule. I will follow his rule to whatever end.
Ah, but would you rather not be part of an empire that has no end?
Sir?
Listen to me, Governor. I have seen the Empire's end. I have had a vision of an Imperial banner engulfed in flames over a green orb, and the flag of the rebels rising, flowing invincibly in the wind. This vision will come to pass. And soon.
I'm sorry, Lord Jerec, but I don't understand. The Rebel Alliance conquering the Empire.
Oh, yes. Make no mistake, Governor. If the battle at Yavin was any indication, they are a force to be reckoned with. Palpatine underestimates them, but I sense that you do not.
I feel we cannot afford to underestimate them.
Indeed, we cannot. But our dear Emperor does not feel the same way. His mind has grown stale. His power has grown stale. The Empire has become stale. It is time for a new power, and I can feel new power coursing through me.
Sir, what you are saying could be considered treasonous.
Why do you insist on... Of course, Captain, of course. There I go, getting wrapped up in my own thoughts. They're just musings, after all.
Well... I see we are finished here. Would you care for a tour of the shipyard?
I'm afraid our time here has run out. We must continue our voyage to Imperial Center. But I may indeed return to inspect the vessels at a future date. Captain Throng, prepare the shuttle for liftoff.
Yes, sir.
Governor, I want you to know, if any factions within the Empire were to rise up to overthrow Palpatine, they would have my full support. Such power here. I feel...
I look forward to your return with pleasure, Lord Jerec.
As do I, Governor. May it be sooner than later. And do not forget what I said, Governor. We shall speak again.
Thinks I will let him take the throne, he is gravely mistaken. There will be no place for the likes of him in the true Empire. Once the Emperor is dead, he too shall die, along with Thrawn. Commander Hawk?
Lord Teivel?
Contact the Board of Commanders. We will meet in the conference room at once.
Yes, sir. I will see to it.
And... contact Valacor. We will require his services sooner than anticipated. We are going to have to make some alterations to the plan.
Kyle, Jan, it is so good to have you back again and to see you alive and well.
Well, we're alive at least.
It's good to be home. Once again, the Alliance is indebted to both of you.
Well, you can start paying off that debt by giving us some time to relax.
I'm sure you speak for everyone in the Alliance. Now, where is he?
The Colonel? Asleep in one of the cargo compartments. I tried to wake him up, but he stuck a blaster in my face.
That sounds like him, all right.
Yeah, it looks like him, too.
Dalvin! Oh, I just have to give you a hug.
That's all right. It's good to be back. So this is the new base, huh? A little ragged around the edges, ain't it?
It's only ragged, because this is a temporary base. Our scouts are out searching for a new location. Until then... Dalvin, I'm sorry we didn't come soon.
Don't apologize. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't upset at first, but when I heard about Yavin, what I'm trying to say is, I understand. I'm just glad to be back. 8 years is a long time to be away. I bet there's plenty of new people for me to meet.
Lady Mothma!
Commander Reese, what is it?
We're ready for the meeting, my lady.
Very good. Come. It's time to get things underway.
Nicea makes no difference, General Krell. My fleet is not as strong as yours, yet you have more doubts than the rest of us combined. Explain this!
Doubt is not always a sign of weakness, if that is what you are suggesting.
Indeed, I am not. I am suggesting that you are afraid.
Watch what you are saying, Admiral Khan. I fear nothing. I am being cautious, that is all.
Caution is, of course, necessary.
And I've had just enough of your pettiness, Captain Vilmer. Sometimes I wonder if we shouldn't have you done away with here and now before it's too late.
So you think it would be better to throw caution to the wind and just leap into the fire, guns blazing? If this true Empire is ever to see the light of day, we cannot act recklessly. That was Moff Tractor's undoing. And I ought to know. I served under him during that time, during that very movement. I survived because I stepped lightly. He did not.
Yes. And how do we know that you didn't rat him out?
I can only give you my word that I did not. I am no traitor.
And yet, here you sit, planning mutiny against the Emperor.
That's because
Gentlemen, as much as I would love to sit here and listen to you all strain your vocal cords, that is not why I called this meeting.
Well, what did you call us for?
I'm afraid we have a few more details to worry about. We had a visitor a short while ago.
A visitor? Who?
Was it the Emperor again?
No. But almost as bad, if not worse. Jerec.
Lord
Jerec?
Yes, he was here. And we had a very interesting dinner. Jerec knows what we are planning.
We're done for!
This is not good.
If he knows,
not good at all.
He will tell the Emperor. Even my XO doesn't know.
But, this is not our main concern.
What else is there?
What is the main concern?
The High Inquisitor has voiced his support.
Support?
Whoa, hold on. Back up a second here. Why would he support us?
I am afraid Jerec is, how shall we put this, blind to our real plans. He believes that once we overthrow Palpatine, we will look to him as our new ruler.
Preposterous.
That's absurd.
Indeed.
Dispatching the Emperor and Lord Vader was going to be difficult enough. And now this!
Jerec has four Dark Jedi under his command.
This was always an inevitable detail in our plans. And yes, it would be dangerous if they were together. But spread across the galaxy...
Across the galaxy?
Yes. My contacts inform me that each of them is on a separate mission. Falkris to Deneba, Maw to Corellia, and Vonkar to Krildor.
But that's only three.
The fourth, Volos, is unaccounted for. He was at Imperial Center until recently, but I was just informed he has not been seen since yesterday.
So, what? You plan to hunt them down?
No, General Krayl. I don't plan to hunt them down. But I know others who will. Valakor!
What the... Oh, my.
Gentlemen, this is Valakor and Vakhti, an Aetherian Dalor from Rolfara. He is also a bounty hunter. And... a Jedi hunter.
I've never even heard of this Valakor. Surely a Jedi hunter would have a reputation.
That is not how Valakor works. And that is why I chose him. And I chose other hunters as well. All work in secret. Valakor, however, is the best of them. He has slain 8 Jedi, including 4 Masters, and 2 Dark Jedi.
And do we have more than his word to substantiate that claim?
Why don't you take a look in the satchel he has thrown on the table before you, Admiral?
What is this? Let me guess. Nightsabers.
Open the bag, Admiral.
By the moons of... faces! You've carved off your victims' faces!
Yes! These are faces of Valakor's victims. 2 students. 4 masters. And 2 Dark Jedi.
I believe you! Now please, take them away!
Yes, gentlemen. I believe Valakor is the solution to our troubles.
It's great to see you again, sir.
Ah, Athar Kate. It's great to see you. You ever have time to start a family?
Not yet, sir. And I have a feeling you never had a chance for that vacation to Bythrum, either.
I wish. Still planning to, though. Hey, where's Landon?
Captain Orid? He...
When? How?
Last year. He was leading a rebel cell off of Bomb Creel. Imperials attacked, and most of the fleet went down.
I'm sorry, Ethar.
He died in the line of duty. He wanted it that way.
So, how have you been doing these past 8 years without a cyborg to carry you around?
You know, there's something familiar about that voice. Blair!
Colonel Ledok?
Well, let me get a good look at you. Very nice. And your voice, you look and you sound great.
All thanks to metatechnology. It's really good to see you, Dalvin.
It's good to see everyone again. I'd forgotten how many friends I had here. And how many I've lost.
You heard about Jaden and her family. From what I understand, their sacrifice at Yavin... Well, the Alliance will be forever indebted to them. So, how'd prison treat you?
Oh, wonderful. All the, hospitality you'd expect from the Imperials.
For all we know, you were just vacationing in the Outer Rim these past 8 years.
Shh, don't tell anyone.
Let us begin. To bring certain new faces up to speed, this is the Cortana system, located on the border of the Cool Room. It is under the jurisdiction of...
All right, you all know the plans. Designated team leaders Major Ariadne and Captain Tanner will give you more in-depth information on your way to Cortani 3. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot stress to you enough how important this mission is. Not only will it deprive the Empire of a prize shipyard, not only will it prevent the completion of 3 new superweapons, but it will be a time for vengeance for the Rakan.
Get as much rest as you can. Departure time is at 1400 hours. May the Force go with us.
This should be fun.
Isn't it always? Jan.
Yeah?
I'm going to be in the hangar patching up the Crow.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I need a drink.
Sounds good.
You guys are hitting the simulators. I want you all at peak performance for this mission. That means no slacking off and no drinking.
And no fun.
Yep.
Katarn, obviously you and Ors are exempt for now, since you have to attend to your ship. Once you're finished...
Major Ariadne, Captain Tanner.
Yes?
Yes?
Could I speak with you both a moment?
Remember, men, peak performance. I'll be back to check on your progress.
I outrank her, for Griff's sake. How come she gets to boss me around?
She's one of the designated team leaders, so she gets to call the shots.
Designated team leader, my...
Come on, let's go. You will only reveal this information to the specific team members. Is that understood?
Of course, m'lady.
Yes, Lady Mothma. This information is of the utmost importance and could be very dangerous if it were spread.
Indeed. It could cause much fear and uncertainty in a time when courage and hope are desperately needed.
Understood.
Well, if that is all, I am going to eat dinner. Either of you care to join me?
No. Thank you. If you will excuse me, there are things I have to do before we leave. Captain? M'lady?
What about you, m'lady?
Oh, no. Thank you, Captain Tanner. It's been a long day, and I desperately need rest.
Very well, then. I'll see you in the hangar tomorrow.
Oh, Captain.
M'lady?
Do you think this will work?
It will work, m'lady. After our victory at Yavin, the spirits of these men and women have never been higher.
Let us hope that victory has not made us overconfident.
Never. That's the Emperor's expertise. Well, until tomorrow then.
Good night, Captain. Oh, Captain.
Yes?
Thank you.
Star Wars Crusade of the Rebellion, Episode 3, by Joe Harrison. Based on characters and situations created by George Lucas. Featured in the cast were Jesse Lowther as Grand Moff Teivel, Amy Farrell as Jan Ors, Ashton Howard as Kyle Katarn, Joe Harrison as Colonel Ledok, Silas Carter as Mon Mothma and Blair Tyson, Andrew Gilbertson as Captain Tanner, Julia Harrison as Major Ariadne, River Canoff as General Crail, Christopher Walker as Admiral Karn, James Leeper as Captain Vilmer, Kevin Trainer as Commander Hawk, Eric Ulp as Commander Cade, Corey M. Hilton as Imperial Officer No. 2 and Commander Reeds, Paul Im as Stormtrooper No. 1, Miles Rand as Stormtrooper No. 2, Wayne Shearer as Valicor, Jonathan Bullock as Imperial Officer No. 1, with Brian Turner as Captain Thrawn, and featuring a special guest appearance by Alan Hamilton as Lord Jerec. This is River Canoff. Star Wars Crusade of the Rebellion was distributed by Lion's Mouth Entertainment and directed by Joe Harrison. Sound design for Lucasfilm by Ben Burtt. Music by John Williams. Additional music by Mark Griske. Story and sound engineering by Joe Harrison. Story editing and script supervision by Julia Harrison. Mixing and post-production were realized in Adobe Audition and Audacity. Special thanks to Brian Daly, Tom Vagley, Wayman Models and Talent, Sound 80, Nathan P. Butler, Star Wars Fanworks, and GalacticSenate.com. And a very special thanks to George Lucas. Star Wars Crusade of the Rebellion will continue in Episode 4, coming soon to LionsMouthENT.net. This production was produced for and by the fans. All materials, including music, names, and sound effects, are copyright to their original creators. No infringing claims are intended.
Lion's Mouth Entertainment is a non-profit company and is not endorsed by or affiliated with Lucasfilm Limited or the Walt Disney Company. Story copyright 2015 by Joe Harris.